Hello and welcome to this wonderful course of computer network. And today we are going to discuss two key functions of network core. The first one is routing and the second one is forwarding. So as I told you earlier as well that network core has two things to operate. The first one is your circuit switching network and the second one is packet switch network. The biggest example of circuit switch network is PSTN, public switch telephone network, which I told you earlier as well in the last lecture. And the second part is packet switch network, and the biggest example of packet switch network is internet. So internet uses packet switch network, and in packet switch network we send the data in the form of packets, and at network layer of TCP/IP protocol suite we have two tasks to perform, routing and forwarding. Routing means like this is network core where it's a mashup router where all the routers are connected with each other, and if you send some data from source router to the destination router, so here in this case routing means path followed by the packet from source to destination. And in fact, it should be the shortest path used by packet or message from source router to the destination router is called routing, or as it says as well, that determines the source destination route taken by packets. So this route is determined by this process is called routing, and this particular route, shortest routes are determined by your routing protocols, which we are going to study in detail at network layer. And routing protocols or algorithms are used for finding the shortest path between two end nodes in a network, and these routing algorithms forms routing tables in each and every router. As you can see, this is the example of a routing table which you have in front of you, where you have a header value at the left column and you have output link at the right column. So this you can like assume these header values are the destination IP addresses which you will find in your incoming packets. Let's take an example of this particular router. This particular router is got four serial ports, 1, 2, 3, and 4, and this routing table belongs to this particular router, as you can see the projection. So the incoming packet is coming to its fourth serial port, and this particular packet is got destination IP address. This particular IP address is taken out by this router, and this particular destination IP address will be matched with this particular column. And when you find the perfect match of this particular IP address in this particular column, you will get the output link or output serial port which is written against these values. Like let's take an example of this value 0111. So 0111 is the third value in this column, and against this we found serial port number 2. So this particular packet should be sent through its destination through serial port number 2, then only this particular packet will reach to its destination in a shortest way. So that is what this particular routing algorithm says. These routing algorithms are formed with the help of these routing tables are formed with the help of routing algorithms, and once you have this routing algorithm, you can easily does the task of data forwarding. What it says, let's see. Move packets from router's input to appropriate router output port. So data forwarding means when this particular packet comes to this serial port, which is the serial port number 4 at this particular router, then this particular router will decide where to forward this particular packet out of these three serial ports to get this packet at destination in a shortest way. So this thing is decided with the help of routing table. So you first of all, you will find this particular address in this particular column in the routing table. And once you find this particular address, destination address of a router in this particular column, you will try to find the serial port which is written against this particular column, which is 2. And you will forward your packet from this port number 4 to port number 2 to make the journey of this particular packet successful in a shortest way. So placing the packet from input port to the correct output port is called packet forwarding. So I hope you understand the difference between routing and forwarding. Routing means path taken by the packet from source to the destination, and this thing is done with the help of routing algorithms, because routing algorithms are used for finding the shortest path between two nodes. So I hope these two network core network layer functions are clear to you guys. So let's come to the alternative core, which is circuit switching. And the biggest example of circuit switching is PSTN, public switched telephone network, as I told you earlier as well. And this is not the part of internet, but this is the part of network core. And we need to understand this concept, but this is not going to use in our internet or TCP/IP protocol suit. But you must know that the other part of network core, which is circuit switching, how it works actually. So basically, circuit switching is nothing but it works in three phases. The first phase is a data connection, the second phase is data transmission, and the third phase is your connection termination. So during the first phase, you set up the connection between source and destination. And during the second phase, you transmit your data, you communicate with each other over the telephone line. And once you are done with the communication part, the third phase is connection termination. So these are the three phases of circuit switch network. The main part of circuit switch network is all the resources between source and destination. All the resources are reserved for you. So there will be no congestion, no traffic, nothing. Your communication will be smooth, as you must have felt whenever you talk on talk through your dot phones, landline phones, or your cell phone regular connection. It feels very good when you talk over that connection, because all the resources between you and your destination are reserved for you, and it's a kind of circuit between you and your destination. So that's why it feels very good, and there's no hassles, there's no traffic, there's no congestion, there's no nothing like delayed in voice. Let's see what the slide says. End to end resources allocated to reserve for call between source and destination, as I told you just now. That if let's take this node as a source and this node as a destination. So a kind of circuit is formed between these two nodes, and this circuit is reserved for only these two resources. And when something is reserved for you, it's like it's completely dedicated to you only. Like no other node will intervene in that particular resources. So it's completely for you. In diagram, each link has four circuits, as you can see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and call gets second circuit in top link and first circuit in right link, as you can see, second and first. Dedicated resources, no sharing, circuit like guaranteed performance, circuit segment idle if not used by call, no sharing, commonly used in traditional calling. So the main thing is this, you will get guaranteed bandwidth and you get the performance, but circuit segment idle if not used by call. If you're not using your resources during the data transmission phase, then these resources are waste. No other person, no other node can use these resources. These resources are fully dedicated for you. So that is why there is a third phase. During that, you release your resources during the connection termination phase. So three phases are there. Setup phase, you reserve all the resources which are coming in your way to the destination, and during a data transmission phase, you communicate with each other. And the third phase is connection termination phase, and during that phase, you release all the resources which you acquired for the communication. So that is how your circuit switching works, and will not go in more details with this particular topic, but you must know what circuit switching is and what is the example of circuit switching. Okay, let's switch to the next slide, and in this slide we see circuit switching FDM versus TDM. This FDM stands for frequency division multiplexing. I hope you must have heard about these terms. And TDM stands for time division multiplexing. So these are the two ways to share the resources. As you can see in this particular diagram, that during the data transmission phase, these resources, these links are reserved for these two nodes only. But you can share these links as well among other nodes as well. If there are more number of nodes are there to share or communicate with each other, then you can share these dedicated link which are reserved for these two resources only. So how you are going to share these resources? So there are two ways to share these resources. First is FDM and second is TDM. So let's see how FDM works. You have the vertical axis is frequency and the horizontal axis is for time, and you can see you have this much of frequency. And what you can do during frequency division multiplexing, if you have four users, what you do, you divide your frequency, complete frequency, into four frequency bands. As you can see, you have divided the complete frequency into four frequency bands, and you will share this particular frequency with four users. So for user one, this particular blue color frequency band is reserved. For user two, this particular mehndi color band is reserved, then yellow, and then pink for the fourth user. So with the help of FDM, you can share your resources in circuit switching as well. And how you're going to share that particular thing, those resources, with the help of FDM, which you just saw, you divide the frequency band and share these frequency bands with the users. So that is how it works. Now we see TDM, time division multiplexing. In this, you can see you have a vertical axis for frequency and horizontal axis for time. And this time, what you're going to do, you are going to share time slots instead of a frequency band. You will share complete frequency with a particular user only for a particular time slot. And let's suppose if you have four users, then what's going to happen, as you can see over here, that during this first time slot, user one, which has got blue color, will get the chance to transmit the data. And immediately after this particular time slot, the second user will get complete frequency for this particular time slot. Once you are done, once this particular user is done with its part, then user third user will get its chance to communicate with each other, and it will get its time slot along with the complete frequency band. So that is how TDM works. So these are the two ways to share resources in circuit switch network: FDM and TDM, frequency division multiplexing and time division multiplexing. So I hope these things are clear to you guys, and if you have any issues with a particular topic or with anything, we will discuss that thing in our discussion class. Thank you very much. Have a nice day.